and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on pressure, volume, and temperature relationships. So anytime the conditions for a gas change, but the number of moles of that gas remains the same, the ideal gas law can be simplified. Remember that R in the ideal gas law is a constant, and if the number of moles, or N, remains the same, then N is also a constant. And so the ideal gas law can be simplified to P1 times V1 divided by T1 equals P2 times V2 divided by T2, where the variables with the subscript 1 are the initial conditions of the gas, and the variables with the subscript 2 are the final conditions of the gas. And if, in addition to the number of moles, the volume, temperature, or pressure also remains constant, then you can again simplify the ideal gas law even further to one of the following forms. Now, anytime you're doing one of these problems, you don't necessarily have to use one of these simplified equations. You can use the ideal gas law, but by using one of these simplified equations, you can usually save yourself a lot of time. Let's try an example problem. The volume of a gas is 25.2 liters at 25 degrees Celsius and 0.925 atmospheres of pressure. What is the volume if the temperature decreases to 0 degrees Celsius and the pressure decreases to 665 torr? For this problem, we're going to use the simplified form of the ideal gas law. P1 times V1 divided by T1 equals P2 times V2 divided by T2. If we rearrange this equation to solve for V2, or the final volume, we get that the final volume is equal to the initial pressure times the initial volume multiplied by the final temperature, all divided by the initial temperature times the final pressure. We can then start plugging in these numbers. Remember, we're starting with a pressure of 0.925 atmospheres, a volume of 25.2 liters, and we're going to a final temperature of 273 Kelvin. So remember, when using the ideal gas law or any variation of, you must have temperatures in units of Kelvin. We divide this by the initial temperature, 298 Kelvin, multiplied by the final pressure, 665 torr. And what you'll notice is that units of Kelvin will cancel out, but our units of pressure, atmospheres and torr, won't cancel out, so we need to use a conversion factor. And the conversion factor we'll use is that 760 torr are equal to 1 atmosphere. I have units of atmospheres on the bottom, so they'll cancel with units of atmospheres on the top, and units of torr on the top, so they'll cancel with units of torr on the bottom. This will leave us with an answer in units of liters, which is an appropriate unit for volume. So the final volume of this gas, when the temperature's decreased and the pressure's decreased, is 24.4 liters. Let's try another example. Mylar balloons filled with helium gas will explode if filled in room temperature and then left in a hot car for too long. If an average helium balloon has a volume of 14 liters while full and has a pressure of 1.01 atmospheres at room temperature, or 25 degrees Celsius, what is the pressure when the temperature rises to 40 degrees Celsius, assuming the balloon doesn't pop? Because not only the number of moles are remaining constant, but the volume is also remaining constant, we can simplify the ideal gas law even further to come up with the relationship: the initial pressure divided by the initial temperature is equal to the final pressure divided by the final temperature. When we rearrange this equation to solve for the final pressure, we get that the final pressure is equal to the initial pressure times the final temperature, all divided by the initial temperature. We're starting with an initial pressure of 1.01 atmospheres. Our final temperature is 313 Kelvin, which is what we get when we convert 40 degrees Celsius to Kelvin. And then we divide that by the initial temperature, 298 Kelvin. This allows units of Kelvin to cancel and leaves us with a pressure in units of atmospheres, or 1.06 atmospheres. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.